Hey everyone, got some exciting news to share today. For Block 2 ships, SpaceX has changed its stacking process. Instead of stacking the entire ship in one step, they first assemble the nose cone and payload bay in Star Factory. These sections are then moved to Mega Bay 2 for final stacking. This method was used for Ship 33, 34, and 35 in the High Bay, but is now being done inside Star Factory for Ship 36. Once the nose cone and payload are stacked, the forward section will be added. Ship 35 is the first to use a double lift method for stacking. Instead of using a squid to lift the nose cone, SpaceX is now attaching the lifter at four points. This new approach could improve efficiency as they refine the assembly process. On the other hand, Elon Musk is pushing forward with his Mars mission plans, and this time he's bringing artificial intelligence into the mix. By the end of 2026, SpaceX aims to send a Tesla bot powered by xAI's AI model, Grok, on its next Mars mission. Musk made the announcement during a live stream on X on February 18th. He introduced xAI's latest AI model, Grok 3, and discussed its potential applications. He also confirmed that most of SpaceX's Mars projects are scheduled for the last quarter of 2026. The timing aligns with the next Earth-Mars transit window in November 2026, a crucial launch opportunity that comes every 26 months. Musk said, "If all goes well, SpaceX will send Starship rockets to Mars with Optimus robots and Grok. This means the upcoming mission could mark the first time AI-driven robots land on another planet, setting the stage for automated exploration and development." Grok 3 is already proving itself as a powerful AI. In a recent blind evaluation by Chatbot Arena, it outperformed leading AI models from Google, OpenAI, and DeepSeek. The test involves users asking questions to two unidentified AI chatbots and ranking their responses. With over a million votes cast, Grok 3 achieved a record-breaking score of 1,400 and continues to improve. Musk and his team at xAI are updating it regularly to enhance its capabilities. The AI model is excellent in several areas, including coding, math, creative writing, and instruction following. It also leads in handling complex prompts and multi-turn conversations. These abilities make it a strong candidate for supporting future missions beyond just Mars. Meanwhile, Booster 15 recently set a new record. After a successful 33-engine static fire, it rolled back to Mega Bay 1 in just 61 hours. This beats the previous record of 4 days set by Booster 14. SpaceX quickly mounted Booster 15, tested it, and rolled it back in less than 3 days. With its testing complete, Booster 15 is now in preparations for launch, undergoing final checks, modifications, and assembly of its hot stage ring. Ship 34 has also been busy. It rolled out to Massey's test site on February 10th and deployed its flaps on the 11th before conducting a long-duration static fire that night. Typically, SpaceX fires ships for around 10 seconds, but this test lasted nearly a minute. The last time a ship was fired at night was Ship 24 in August 2022. After this record test, Ship 34 rolled back to Mega Bay 2 in just 72 hours, another milestone in SpaceX's increasingly fast testing process. The reason for this long static fire has been explained by the team. SpaceX revealed that it tested new hardware and ran the 6 Raptor engines at different thrust levels. This helps simulate real flight conditions and improves the propulsion system. The test is likely a response to the anomaly seen in Ship 33's flight, where a major leak in the engine bay led to the vehicle's destruction. SpaceX has not confirmed the exact cause, but this new test suggests they're reinforcing propellant lines and making other structural improvements. While it's unclear if all future ships will undergo long static fires, this test provided valuable data. Massey's flame trench was designed for longer tests, but the recent one may have pushed its limits. Some molten debris was seen flying from the trench, meaning SpaceX may need to reinforce the area. Luckily, the next ship in line, Ship 35, has just finished stacking and hasn't even started cryoproof testing, giving SpaceX time for adjustments. At the launch pad, SpaceX tested the chopsticks with quick close tests at catch height, possibly checking for software updates or minor repairs. Crews continue to work on pad refurbishment, including repainting the legs and the launch mount deck. SpaceX also received approval for its wastewater permit from the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality, clearing up previous issues related to the deluge system. This brings the company one step closer to full environmental compliance for future launches. In the meantime, NASA's achieved something groundbreaking. For the first time, a laser message has traveled from deep space to Earth, covering a massive 16 million kilometers. This is part of the Deep Space Optical Communications Experiment, a technology that could change how humans send and receive data across space. Instead of relying on traditional radio signals, TSOC uses near-infrared lasers to transmit information much faster, up to 100 times quicker than current methods. This test was made possible by the Psyche aircraft, launched in October 2023 aboard a SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket. Psyche's on a mission to explore a metal-rich asteroid, but it also carries DSOC to test next-generation communication systems. Sending a laser across millions of kilometers is no small task. Both Psyche and Earth are constantly moving, making it extremely difficult to keep the beam aligned. The laser photons took about 50 seconds to reach Earth, and in that short time, both the spacecraft and the planet had shifted positions. NASA engineers designed an advanced tracking system to keep the laser locked onto its target despite these challenges. The success of this test is a major step toward real-time communication with future deep space missions. Faster data transfer could support high-definition video streams, improve remote spacecraft operations, and eventually enable astronauts on Mars to communicate with Earth more efficiently. This kind of breakthrough is essential as space agencies plan for human exploration beyond the Moon. Beyond its role in advancing communication technology, Psyche is set to reach its destination, the asteroid Psyche, in 2028. Scientists believe this asteroid may be the exposed core of an ancient planetary body. Studying it could reveal key information about how planets, like Earth, formed billions of years ago. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.